approximately what year did you start doing that type of work, non-union carpentry work?
About 63.
And how long did you work as a non-union carpenter?
3 years, till 66.
And after 1966, did you actually become a union carpenter?
Yes.
And how long were you a union carpenter?
40 years. Still am.
As you sit here today, do you believe you were exposed to asbestos or asbestos-containing products during your time as a non-union carpenter between 1963 and 1966?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it was. Yes, I was.
How do you believe you were exposed to asbestos, sir?
Through the joint compound.
Where were you exposed to joint compound, sir?
In department buildings, I was exposed to it through sanding it and mixing it and whatever.
Could you just walk the jury through the steps that you would observe when drywall work was being done?
Well, I would hang the board, and then apply the joint. They'd mix the joint compound up, apply it to the seams and the corners and the walls and the nail holes, and sand it, apply another coat and sand it again, apply another coat and sand it again, to the finish.
What, if anything, would you see when drywall applicators would dump joint compound into their mixing pans?
Well, I'd see the dust come up when they're pouring it in.
And what, if anything, would you see when the drywall applicators would add water to the joint compound in their mixing pans?
The dust also would come up when...
What would they use to sand the joint compound, sir?
It's a little piece of hand sandpaper, and then they use a sanding pole.
And what, if anything, would you see in the air when drywall applicators sanded the joint compound?
The dust.
Sir, earlier you mentioned something about cleaning up. Did you personally clean up at this job site?
Yes.
What would you need to clean up?
I clean up the floors and any of the dust and stuff that was on my trim and the cabinets and whatever.
And would anybody else clean up at this job site besides you?
Sometimes drywallers would be helping me. They do theirs, some.
What, if anything, would you see in the air when you swept up the joint compound dust?
Yes, dust.
And where were you in relation to that dust, sir?
I was right in the dust.
As you sit here today, do you believe you were exposed to asbestos or asbestos-containing products at any time while you were working as a union carpenter?
Yes.
How do you believe you were exposed, sir?
Through the fireproofing and the insulation materials they were using.
How was that being applied, sir?
They were spraying it.
This spraying of fireproofing, could you please explain the process that you observed for the jury?
Yes, they had a hopper, a machine, and they would put it in the bags of the fluff in there, and they would mix it all up, and it would go in, they'd shoot it through a hose, and it would spray out with water mixed with it, then it would stick to the beams.
And what, if anything, would you see in the air when the fireproofers would dump the bags of material into the hopper you described?
There'd be dust coming up.
And what would you see, if anything, in the air when the fireproofing material was being sprayed?
Some mist you'd see coming down.
Is this the only way you believe you were exposed to asbestos through the fireproofing material?
No, I used to take it off the beams and sweep it up and clean it up.
Why would you have to disturb the fireproofing material, sir?
If we had to do any work up on the beams at all or attach anything to the beams, we'd always have to chip it off to where we wanted to fasten to whatever we had to weld on there or put our door buck things on or anchors or whatever we had to do.
How did you clean up the fireproofing material, sir?
I'd sweep it up a lot of times off the stuff, off the floor. If I had to snap lines, I'd be cleaning up off the floor
and
sweeping it.
And when you'd sweep up this fireproofing material, what, if anything, would you see in the air?
It'd be dust from it.
A few minutes ago, you mentioned that you believed you were exposed to asbestos through insulation material. Where were those insulation materials being used?
In the boiler room area.
More specifically, what particular areas of the boiler room area were the insulation materials being applied?
They were being applied to the boiler and the pipes in the boiler area.
What insulation materials did you observe them using?
The pipe insulation and the block insulation for the boiler.
Now, let me just focus on the pipe insulation. Can you describe what that looked like, sir?
It was a half moon thing, half round, looked like a tube with a half round with a pipe hole in it. It was a white, chalky material.
What would they use to cut the pipe insulation, sir?
A little saw.
Do you have any understanding as to why they would cut it?
Because it didn't fit into the areas they had to cut it.
Now, focusing on block insulation that you just testified about, can you describe what the block insulation looked like?
It was a block, white, chalky, black, white, chalky stuff.
How do you believe you were exposed to asbestos through this block insulation?
They were cutting it also around the pipes and that, sweeping it up, sweeping up the dust. They had some cement. They would butter up the gaps in the pipes and the joints.
And can you describe what that cement looked like, sir?
It was a powder form. They'd mix it with water. Well, when they were mixing it, and the dust would come up when they were mixing it.
How has this mesothelioma affected you emotionally?
Well, I just don't know what's going on anymore. I'm going to make it.
My last question, sir. What are your thoughts for the future?
I don't know right now, Fred. Just kind of make it through somehow.